stay right where you are. It's Cyberchase for real.
This is my cousin Z.
Hi.
When we were younger, our family spent lots of time together at a beach on Long Island Sound. Long Island Sound is a small body of water where fresh water, like this river, meets with salt water from the ocean. We always had a great time.
Today we visited a place where we can see animals that live beneath the surface of the sound, the Maritime Aquarium at Norwalk.
First, we saw the harbor seals. They were so much fun to watch.
And their numbers are growing because of laws that protect them. Keeping the water clean in Long Island Sound ensures they have plenty of healthy food to eat. The harbor seals have lots of company in Long Island Sound. It's hard to believe so many different creatures, more than 1,000 species, share the water right near New York City.
Yikes, those teeth are scary.
But as you can see, since there are divers in there, sand tiger sharks are not a threat to humans. A green sea turtle can get this big just eating vegetables.
These moon jellies are so beautiful.
River otters have thick fur that keeps them warm in the cold water.
They look like swimming kites. We fed rays, touched a sea star, and my new favorite, a horseshoe crab.
Horseshoe crabs have been around more than 450 million years, since before the dinosaurs.
They are a really important source of food for migrating birds, which eat their eggs.
And scientists have found that a substance in their blood is an important ingredient for medicine that prevents infections.
Since they are so important for animals as well as humans, scientists here are exploring ways to increase their numbers.
They're figuring out ways to grow horseshoe crabs in the lab from eggs.
A sign next to the lab asks, "How can you help horseshoe crabs?"
Become a citizen scientist and help us tag horseshoe crabs each spring.
We wanted to help. The lab scientist told us that anyone can become a citizen scientist to help collect data for research projects. Then she explained how volunteers put tags on the hard shell of horseshoe crabs in a way that doesn't hurt them.
Once horseshoe crabs from the wild are tagged on the beach, scientists can monitor them to understand their patterns of movement and keep count of the number living in the Long Island Sound area.
So we're planning to become citizen scientists. We'll help out with tagging horseshoe crabs in the spring, even though it means going to the beach when the horseshoe crabs gather to lay their eggs at midnight.
So no need to bring the suntan lotion.
Watch your favorite shows anytime on the PBS KIDS video app.